Good morning everyone. So today we'll be discussing about SQL joins. So why do we need joins actually? So when we want to retrieve the data from two or more tables, so then this join would be more helpful to retrieve the data, right? Suppose we have two relations or we have two tables, right? So this is an employee table. And we have one more table, department table. Right. So what this employee relation will tell you about? The employee relation will tell you about the details of the employee. See, what are the attributes that we have in the employee relation? We have employee number, employee name, and employee address. So any kind of employee details you can retrieve from the employee table. And at the same time, in the department relation, how many attributes do we have? We have department number, department name, and the employee number. So see here, the employee number is there in the employee table as well as department table. Means employee number acts as a foreign key. So what is taking the reference? So this foreign key, we are taking the reference from employee, where the employee number will become a primary key in the employee relation, right? So in the previously we have seen how to declare a foreign key and primary key as well. Now if I want to retrieve the employee address from the employee, can we retrieve? Yes. So what do we have to do? I want to retrieve the employee address of Varun. So how do I write the query here? Now I will use a select statement. So what am I selecting? Which data I want to retrieve? I need to retrieve employee address. So I'll give employee address. So from where I have to retrieve this employee address? From the table name. And what is the table name here? Employee. Now, should I retrieve all the addresses? No. What is my query? I need the address of Varun. So what is the condition here? I need the address of Varun. So in where clause, what should I read? Where employee name is equals to Varun. So what happens now? So any query that we write in the SQL, it starts executing from the from clause. What is a from clause here? From the table name. So it will select the employee table. And where, what is the condition here? Where ename equals to Varun. So where ename equals to Varun, this entire tuple will be selected. Now what is the select condition here? I need to only select the address. And what is the address of Varun here? Vishakhapatnam. So simply, what is the output I'll get? VSKP. So in the same way, even to retrieve the department number or the department name, I can write a query on the department relation. So writing the short queries, writing the queries from a single relation. So this will be easy. Writing a single query from the single relation will be more easier. But what if I need to retrieve the employee address who is working in IT department, right? So what is my query is? I need to retrieve the employee address who is working in IT department. Now what happens here? So I need to join this table and this table too, because the department names or the department details are there in the department relation and the employee details are there in the employee relation. So here, when I want to retrieve the data from two or more tables, then I have to use SQL joins. So structured query language joins. So the name itself, join, The name itself specifies what is join. We are joining the tables. To retrieve the data, we are joining the tables. Now, in order to join, we have to, in SQL join, you have to use the keyword join here. You need to use the keyword join. So using join keyword, you can combine any two tables and then we can retrieve the data. Right? So using join, you can combine any number of tables, and then we can retrieve the data that we want. So here remember one point that when we are joining any tables, any one of the attributes should be there in common. Right? So when we are combining any two tables, at least one attribute should be there in common. So see here we have an employee relation and the department relation too. So what is the common attribute here? Employee number is the common attribute, right? So if you have the common attribute, at least one, then we will be able to join the tables. Then we will be able to combine the tables. What is join? Simply, a join is nothing but fetching the data from two or more tables, right? And how these two or more tables will look like? So these tables, the data in these two tables will appear as single set of data. The data in the two tables will appear as single set of data, right? So this is about join. What is join here? A join is nothing but fetching the data from two or more tables, so which will be appeared as single set of data. Okay, so now, why it is used? When we are combining, so it is used for combining column from two or more tables using the common values. So how do we join the tables? If you have any common attributes, then only the join is possible. And simply we can tell that a join is a cross product. A join is a cross product plus select statement. Right? Now you need to know about what is cross product, right? So you need to know about the cross product. So in this lecture only we'll be seeing different types of joins also. So let us discuss about the cross product. The cross product or cross join is one and the same, right? Cross join or cross product is one and the same. What is cross join here? So let me take a few examples. So I have two relations here, right? I'll name it as relation 1 and here I'll name it as relation 2. So now what I have to do? I want to join these two tables and I can use join keyword to join these two tables. And what kind of join I'm using? Cross join. So you need to use cross join. What is a join? Simply, a join is a cross product plus select statement. So what are the things that you are selecting? So maybe you can write, so select, okay. So you can retrieve all the columns or you can retrieve any one of the column. So here I'll writing select star from whatever the tables that we want to merge. Okay, so here how many relations do we have? I have relation 1 and relation 2. So simply I can write select star from relation 1 cross join relation 2. So now what happens? So simply as we mentioned, a join is nothing but a cross product plus select statement. So here we have mentioned the cross join and here I have written the select statement. So now what happens here? When I mention the cross join is nothing but So see here. So how many number of columns will be always equals to number of columns in the first row plus number of columns in the second relation, right? So always the cross join, the ultimate, that resultant table would be the number of, always the columns will be equals to number of columns in the first relation, which is nothing but m, plus the number of rows in the second relation. When we are finding the cross joining, when we are finding the cross product between the two tables, the number of columns will be always equals to summation of the number of columns in first table as well as the columns in the second table, simply m plus n. So how many attributes are there in the relation 1? 3 plus, and how many columns are there in the relation 2? 3. So totally we have 6 attributes. So in the resultant one, so in the resultant table, what do we have? We have 6 attributes. Now what are all those attributes? Whatever the attributes we have here, right? What are the attributes here? A, B and C, right? So these are the attributes in the relation 1. And what are the attributes in relation 2 we have? In relation 2, we have D, E and C. D, E and C, right? So these are the number of columns in the resultant table. Now how many rows will you have? The number of rows will be equals to number of rows in the relation 1. Suppose if you have X rows into number of rows in the relation 2. If you have Y rows in the relation 2, so these two will be multiplied, right? How many rows do we have? The number of rows will be equals to the rows in relation 1 multiplied by rows in the relation 2, right? So how many rows do we have in the relation 1? 2 rows. 2 into, how many rows do we have in the relation 2? 2 rows we have. So total how many rows you will have? So we have 4 possible rows in the resultant table. 4 possible rows in the resultant table, right? So the resultant table will look like this. Now what will be the data? How will you insert the data here, right? So see here. So first you have 1, 2, 3. This tuple will be multiplied with the tuples in the relation 2. Okay. So 1, 2, 3. This entire tuple will be multiplied with both this tuple and this tuple. So what happens? In the resultant table we have 7, 8, 3. So this row is multiplied by once. And again this row will be multiplied in the next one. Okay, so what is the next tuple here? We have 3, 4, 6. So repeat the same column in the resultant table. Repeat the same tuple in the resultant table, right? So again this tuple will be multiplied with both the tuples in the next table. So 4, 5, 6 is multiplied by 7, 8, 3 as well as same 4, 5, 6 will be multiplied by 3, 4, 6. 4, 5, 6. Right? So this will be the resultant table. So what is the cross product here? So cross product is nothing but combining two relations. Cross product is nothing but combining two relations. And how the two relations will be combined? The columns will be always equal to the number of columns in relation 1 plus number of columns in the relation 2. So in this example, we have 3 plus 3 equals to 6, right? And what will be the number of tuples here? Number of tuples will be always equals to the number of tuples in relation 1 into number of tuples in the relation 2. When we cross join any two tables, what will be the number of columns here? Number of columns will be m plus n. M is nothing but the columns in first relation, n is nothing but the columns in the second relation, right? So this will be the resultant. So what will be the resultant here? Resultant. So here we have 3 plus 3, total 6 columns. So 2 into 2, total 4 tuples, right? So here we have 1, 2, 3. So 7, 8, 3. So one tuple will be multiplied with both the tuples in the second relation. So 7, 8, 3 and 3, 4, 6. So repeat the same tuple 1, 2, 3. And again we have 4, 5, 6. The second one should be again multiplied by the two tuples in the second relation. So 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 3 and 3, 4, 6. So 4, please, you need to repeat 4, 5, 6, right? So this will be the resultant. So what is cross join here? So simply cross joining is nothing but the cross product between the two tables, right? What is cross join? So cross joining is nothing but the cross product between any two tables. So here one point you need to remember is you must have two tables, definitely. So mandatorily you should have two tables and you should have the minimum number of attributes. And any one of the attributes should be there in common. So what is an attribute that is in common here? We have C attribute that is there in common. So you can write like, for the cross join, you can write like select command. So whatever the attributes that you want to retrieve, you can give. Okay. So here I'm writing select star from the table 1, relation 1, cross join relation 2. So now whatever you want, so that condition, so those attributes you need to mention in the select command from the cross product of R1 and R2. Right. So this is one of the join. This is the default join, or I can say this is the basic join everyone needs to learn. Right. So the next is natural join. The name itself says, what is here? We have natural join. Naturally, we are joining these two tables. So how this join will be performed? Okay. So see here, I'm taking employee relation and here I have department relation. So how many relations I have taken? I've taken two relations. One is employee and the other one is department. Right. Retrieve the employee names. Who is working in the departments? Right. I want to know those employees who are working in the departments. Okay. So in the departments, like, so whatever the departments we have, in all the departments, who are all the employees are there? Okay. So now we write the query and how the data will be retrieved. So that we'll see. So what is the relation here? We have a relation employee and here we have a relation department, right? So see here, by seeing the relations itself, we can say what I want to find. I want to find employee names who is working in the departments, right? So what happens here? Employee 1 is working in CSC. Who is employee 1? Varun. Okay. So employee 2 is working in IT department. So who is employee 2? Teja, right? So here employee 3 is working in ECM department. This is the name of the department, ECM department. And who is employee 3? Dharitri. Employee 3 is Dharitri. So now we have another employee, Prithvi, but do we have any information in the department? Means this employee is still not associated with any of the department. So this Prithvi named employee is not associated to any other department. So now what should be the output here? The output should be Varun, Teja and Dharitri. So find the employee names. So these are the employees who is working with the departments. who is working with the departments. Now how the SQL compiler will know to retrieve all these names, okay. So normally we can write a query like, so select, so what I need to select, what I want to have, so I want to retrieve only the names, so here I will write select e name. So from where you need to retrieve the e name here, so select e name, so you need to write table, okay, you need to write table from employee, so this is employee relation and this is department relation, from employee comma department, from employee comma department. Why? Because I want to select the names who is working with all the departments. Half of the data is falling in this table and half of the data is falling in the department table. So I will select from employee comma department. I will select both the columns. I will select both the relations, right? So when I'm selecting employee comma department, it is nothing but I'm selecting from the cross product of employee and department. Means we already know what is cross join, right? So from employee comma department, where you need to write the condition, where what is the clause here? So any one of the attributes should be there in common. How can you join here? So how natural join occurs here? So natural join occurs only if any one of the attribute is equal. Now how do I write here? So these, normally we can say employee number and employee number are same, but which employee numbers? So where employee, what is the relation name here? Employee dot e number means the employee number in the employee table should be equals to employee number in the department relation. So department dot employee number. So now what happens? So employee comma department, this is nothing but cross join or cross product. I can simply say cross product or cross join, right? So how do I cross join here? So only if the employee number in the employee table, means employee dot employee number, should be always equals to the employee number in the department table, department dot employee number. Okay, so now what is a cross product here? Table will look like this. The cross product table will look like this. So for the ease, I have only taken employee number and employee name from the employee table, and from the department table, I have taken department number and employee number. But actually, in when you cross join these two, so employee address and department name will also be combined. Okay, so just for my easiness, I have only taken these things, right? So how do I write the query here? Right, select e name from employee comma department, where employee dot e number should be equals to department dot e number, okay. So this is employee table and this is department table. Now how it will compile? Okay, so see here, employee comma department is nothing but the cross product. Right, this is nothing but the cross product. So what happens here? So first I have taken one, Varun. Okay, so one is nothing but Varun. So this tuple should be multiplied with all the tuples in the department name. So one, Varun. So it is multiplied with 5, 12 and 19. So the same thing is repeating. One Varun is repeating for 5, 12, 19. Okay. So then the second relation, second tuple. What is second tuple? Teja. So this is again multiplied with 5, 12 and 19. So in the same way, third tuple and fourth tuple is also multiplied by 5, 12, 19, 5, 12, 19. Right. Now how it will compile. Okay. So I have selected the E name. So compiler always starts from clause. Okay. From clause. So what is the first here? What is the first clause here? Employee comma department. Employee comma department is nothing but the cross product here. Okay. So cross product. This is a cross product. So I have got the cross product. Now, what is the where clause here? What is the clause I have written? Employee number is equals to department employee number. So these two tuples belongs to employee, right? Sorry, these two columns, these two attributes belongs to employee and these two attributes belongs to department, right? So after cross product, after cross joining these two relations, these two belongs to employee and these two attributes belongs to department. Now what is a clause here? We should have employee dot employee number is equals to department dot employee number. So see here, employee dot employee number is equals to department dot employee number. So this will be selected. Why? Because the employee number in the employee is equals to department employee number. Now check the second tuple. Is this equal? 1 is not equals to 2. Employee number of employee table and employee number of department table is not equal. So this will not be selected. This will not be selected. The same thing will happen for the next tuples too. So is 1 equals to 3? No, 1 is not equals to 3. So here also this tuple will be eliminated. What is the second one? Employee number 2 is equals to 1. 2 is not equals to 1. So employee number in the employee table is not equals to employee number in the department table. So even this is also eliminated. Right? So see here. What is this? 2 is equal to 2. So now what happens? This information you will have. This information it will preserve. Because employee number in the employee and employee number in the department are equal. So it will preserve this. So is this equal? So even this tuple is eliminated because 2 is not equals to 3. So this one is also eliminated. This is also eliminated. So now 3 equals to 3. So this one will be selected. It will preserve this one. Okay, it will preserve this one. Why? Because employee number is equal to employee number of the department. So now see here, 4 is not equals to 1, 4 is not equals to 2, 4 is not equals to 3. So all these tuples will be eliminated. Now how many rows, how many tuples do we have? Here we have first one, second and third. Right. So only these tuples are there after compiling the where condition. After compiling the where condition, so how many tuples do we have? Only 3 tuples we have in the, only 3 tuples we have in the join. Okay. Now what I need to select here? I need to select the employee names. What are the employee names here? Varun. The employee names are Varun, Teja and Dharitri. Varun, Teja and Dharitri. Okay, so these employee names are selected, right? So out of these 3 tuples, what it will select? It will only select the E name. And what is the E name here? Varun, Teja and Dharitri. This will be the output. Okay, so this will be the output. So rather than writing this entire query, so what I can write? So instead of this cross product and where employee E number equal to department E number, I can simply write it as select E name from cross natural join R1 and R2. Okay. okay. So simply how can I write here?
Select e name. Select e name from this one, employee natural join the next relation department. So instead of writing the entire query, so simply what I'm writing, select e name.
So from where I'm selecting?
From employee natural join department.
Natural join itself says that it will join the two tables at least where one column should be equal. Means natural join in the sense, so it will give employee dot e number, e is equal to department dot e number. It will signify that one. So rather than writing the entire query like this, so simply you can write select e name from employee natural join department, right? So understood what is a natural join? So natural join, it will just join. This is a default join in the structured query language. It will join the two tables. How it will join the two tables? Whatever the column that is there in common, so basing on that one, it will join the two tables. It will join the two tables, and after joining, whatever the data we want, so that data you need to write in the select statement. This is one of the join in your SQL. So we have seen what is cross join. Simply the cross product between any two tables. The same thing, how do we write? So select the condition, select attributes from employee cross join department. Employee cross join department. And same the natural join too. So natural join in the sense, so previously we have written the query in the same way. So natural join, at least one column should be in common, and so basing on that column we are joining the two tables. Thank you.